Hello friends, welcome to English for Competitive Exams. My name is Suresh. In this introductory video, let's start by answering a simple question about our country. So what is the most important issue that India is currently facing with? Yes, you're right. Unemployment. Do you know the reason why? I'll tell you. It's because of demographic dividend. Don't worry, I'll simplify it for you. So demographic dividend is a positive concept. So what is it exactly? So demographic dividend is nothing but more number of youngsters as a percentage of overall population, which is from the country perspective is a good scenario because more number of people will be putting in efforts. That means more productive hours, which means GDP growth. At the same time, this has a negative shade as well. That negative shade is unemployment, because there, since when you have more number of people looking for jobs, government has to create those many number of jobs as well. When that doesn't happen, unemployment will be on the rise. This is the scenario today. But there is more bad news for us, because this particular demographic dividend are the number of are the share of working age population as part of as a percentage of overall population is only going to go up in the next 10 to 15 years, which means unemployment levels also will go up in the next 10 to 15 years. I want all of you to keep this in your mind while preparing for competitive examinations. With each passing year, you will have more and more people joining the competition. So we cannot afford to take chances in any subject. And from my perspective, from my side, I am going to help you in one particular subject called English. And my journey with English is an interesting one. I started in 1996 when I first, I was in class 6 then. What happened in 1996 and class 6? I learned alphabets. So it was only in class 6 that I first had a chance to learn English alphabets. You heard it right, it's correct. Because that's how the government school curriculum used to be those days. And I studied in a government school in Telugu medium till class 10. Okay, and then in 2007, I had a chance to test my skills in an examination by name CAT. And there was one more examination by name ZAT. And these are my scores in these two exams. And my scores in verbal again are upwards of 98% in both the examinations. So it's an interesting journey of 11 years of English, because I started in 1996 by learning alphabets, and in 2007 I had a chance to test my skills in all India level examinations called CAT and SAT, and I kind of succeeded in both these examinations. I also had a privilege of working with the several corporate organizations for more than 10 years, and most of them are multinationals like Infosys, Wipro, SAP and Oracle, and you also have Bharti Airtel. No, it's not pure software experience. I started with Infosys as a software engineer, but post which my experience with Wipro, Bharti Airtel, SAP and Oracle is all in customer facing roles, because by then I had already done my MBA. After MBA I joined Wipro, and then these are the other companies where I worked with, and most of them I worked in customer facing roles. So by doing this, I also had additional exposure of having worked with, having numerous conversations with customers, with business managers, with leaders and all that. So that's the additional advantage which I had. So what I would like to do from upcoming videos, I would like to teach you English grammar, English vocabulary, English several other things which you require for the examination, like reading comprehension, sentence correction and all that. And I will tell you the tips and tricks which I developed as a student while preparing for examination. That will be my value add for you. It's not like a typical teacher who always teaches the subjects in the same manner. I come from the student perspective because I was a student myself. And I went through this journey from 1996 to 2007, and I also had a privilege of working with the corporates for more than 10 years, wherein I developed my spoken English skills as well. So let's bring that into perspective. Let me help you by sharing my experiences in these two aspects going forward. So thank you. That's it for this video. Please stay tuned. In a day or two, I'll come up with my first grammar video on tenses. Thank you.